I tried peeking through the cracks, saw the light but couldn't catch it. Now the one is breaking down. You should let me love you, but you're making it so hard to. You've been building up this wall now, and I don't really know how I'm supposed to break it down.
I'm Joe, and you're at the Joe is Hungry channel. I'm at the Huddle House in Calhoun, Georgia, and they've got a new menu item. I don't know if it's new or whether it's a re-release. Anyway, they call it the roasted prime rib tips sandwich. I've got my prime rib tips sandwich. Let's go ahead and do the Joe is Hungry temperature test. This thing is cooking up to 157.1 degrees Fahrenheit. Tip sandwich number two comes in at 160.0 degrees Fahrenheit. That's hot, that's fresh. I know they cooked it fresh. I watched them cook it, so they win the Joe is Hungry temperature test. Now it's time for a little more evaluation. So let's roll on back to the studios of Joe is Hungry, located in my sort of semi-adopted hometown of Fairmount, Georgia. Happy New Year again, everybody. I hope you like my channel. If you like my videos, support me, subscribe. I guess just watch my videos. I just got back from the Huddle House in Calhoun, Georgia. The roasted prime rib tip sandwich consists of tender prime rib tips, Swiss cheese, sautéed mushroom, all on a brioche bun. And it comes with a side order of a zhoo sauce. And for those of you not in the know, that is meat juice. This is part of a limited time four-part menu edition. It consists of course, the prime rib tips sandwich, the prime rib tips dinner, the prime rib tips omelet, and the prime rib tips stuffed hash browns. That actually looks kind of good. Each one of these weighs in at 580 calories. I have the stats up on the screen and in the description below. Each one of these sandwiches will set you back a hefty $9.39. And with each sandwich, you get a side order of French fries or another side of your choice. A lot of them don't cost anything extra. Some of them do. So I have those up on the screen and in the description below. And if you choose no side at all, they're still gonna charge you the $9.39. That I really don't understand.
Oh man!
And this is a limited time offer going through February 1st of 2022. Now it's time for the Joe is Hungry weight test. Huddle House doesn't post any serving weights, so I bought two of these things so I could check for consistency between tip sandwich and beef tip sandwich. Prime rib tip sandwich number one weighs in at 8.05 ounces. Prime rib tip sandwich number two weighs in at 10.50 ounces. That's nearly a 2 ounce spread. I really can't give them a pass on the Joe is Hungry weight test. Now it's time for the Joe is Hungry big reveal.
I don't need you, you. I don't need you. Dump you living. I don't need you, cause I got high ambitions, a boss vision. I'm granting all.
This is what it looks like, and this is what it's supposed to look like. This is what it looks like, and this is what it's supposed to look like. We've seen what it looks like, we saw how much it was. It was a little pricey. They kind of mess it up on the weight test. They did cook it fresh, and this is a very oozy-goozy, messy sandwich. Let me show you, you get plenty of fries with this order, so that kind of makes up for the price a little bit. But there's only one true test, and that is the Joe is Hungry bite test. So it is, to my pleasure, bite test engage. It is definitely a mouthful of meat. It was cooked fresh. You can watch them cook it. You know it is.
fries are about standard fare, although a little under seasoned. The Swiss cheese pulls the sandwich together. The brioche bun keeps it from melting and falling apart in your hands worse than it already did. This is a very messy sandwich, as you saw. It just basically falls apart in your hands. The sautéed mushrooms are really sautéed, and they bring the sandwich together along with the melted Swiss cheese. It really worked. They forgot to give me my zhoo sauce, or the meat juice. It would have made the thing probably a little less dry. I happen to have some meat juice, a zhoo sauce, left over from the Arby's video. Let's give it a shot. If their juice is anything like Arby's juice, it definitely helps the sandwich out. Now it's time to give this thing a score. If y'all don't know my scale is 1 to 10. 9 being the best, anything above 9 is a once in a lifetime experience. 5 and down is on the slippery slopes to the depths of food hell. So let's go ahead and give this thing a number that it truly deserves. Slightly underseasoned, inconsistent in size. They forgot my zhoo sauce. Well, that's a big loss. I'm gonna have to go with a 7.1. That is my number, that is my review, and we will see you in the next video.